ties and screws. When you're finished, you can get a wireless remote control system that pairs with your flight controller so you can fly your drone. Say read steps if you want me to read each step in detail.
Read steps.
Step 1. Find a quadcopter design in a book or online for reference. There are many websites and books devoted specifically to building your own drone. The most common kind of home-built drone tends to start with an X shape that allows you to mount 4 rotors, called a quadcopter. This design is easy to build and is used even on high-end drones. Having a design to follow will help make it easier to decide where best to place each component. Once you've finished a quadcopter drone, you can try larger designs that incorporate more motors to carry more equipment like cameras. Many drone designs are available for free online if you search DIY drone design. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 2. Make a frame for the drone out of metal, plastic, or wood. Begin constructing your frame using the material of your choice. Model plastic, balsa wood, or thin metal, thinner than 0.25 inches, 0.64 centimeters, are best. For a simple quadcopter design, lay 1/12 inch, 30 centimeters, long piece of wood, plastic or light metal across another, so it creates an X shape with 90-degree angles. Each extending arm of the drone frame should reach toward what would be the corner of a perfect square you could draw around the frame. Choose a frame material that is at least 1 inch, 2.5 centimeters, wide to support mounting your engines. You can purchase model plastic, thin metal, or balsa wood at most hobby or model stores. You can also find these materials at drone retailers or on websites like Amazon. Use glue or duct tape to secure the two pieces of your frame together. Don't move on to the next step until the pieces of the frame are secure and any glue you've used has dried. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 3. Purchase motors, propellers, and other electronics from a drone retailer. There are some components of your drone that can't be built from scratch, so you'll need to purchase them. If there is no drone retailer nearby, many hobby stores that carry model rockets and RC airplanes will carry them. You will need to purchase speed controllers, a power distribution board, and a flight controller along with the motors and propellers. If you have trouble finding the parts you need, many drone-specific online retailers, as well as large retailers like Amazon, carry these parts. Drone engines should be rated to produce a total of twice as much thrust as the drone weighs. If your quadcopter will weigh 800 grams, 28 ounces, each engine should produce 400 grams, 14 ounces. So the combined total amount of thrust will equal 1,600 grams, 56 ounces. You can often buy these components in bundles. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 4. Drill holes in the frame to support the motors. Most motors mount using anywhere from 2 to 4 screws. Place one motor at the end of one of the drone's extended arms and make marks where the holes need to be drilled. Then use those holes to guide you when using the drill. If you are using self-setting with screws on a wood or plastic frame, drill the holes smaller than the diameter of the screws so they can work as a guide. If you are using metal, drill holes of the same diameter of the mounting bolts you'll use. You will then need to use nuts on the underside of the bolts to secure them in place. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 5. Cut 4.5 in. 1.3 centimeters, rings from a 4-inch, 10 centimeters, PVC pipe to make landing gear. Lay the pipe on its side and mark it where you'll make your cut. Then use a saw to cut all 4 sections, so you're left with 4 plastic rings made of PVC pipe. These 4 rings will serve as lightweight landing gear for your drone. The cuts don't have to be perfect as long as the rings are thick enough to be sturdy, but the better the finish on your cuts, the better the drone will look. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Last step. Stand the landing gear rings on their side and attach them with duct tape. Place one ring on its side beneath each arm of the drone's frame, then use thin strips of duct tape to secure the rings to the arms. The drone will now stand on its own on your table. You can use glue instead of tape, but make sure it's completely dry before moving on. Keep the rings in the middle of the arms so they don't interfere with the placement of your motors or other components. You've reached the end of the article. Do you want to learn how to do something else? You can ask me now.
Echo, how do I start a charity?
How to start a charity? If you want to start a charity, fill out an application packet for a nonprofit organization with your Secretary of State. Then, you will have to pay a small fee to get a federal employer identification number, or EIN. After you do that, file with the IRS for recognition as a charitable organization. When the paperwork is complete, start raising money for your cause and send it where it is needed. Say read steps, if you want me to read each step in detail.
Read steps.
Step 1. Develop your vision. The creation of a charity comes from a passion for a cause. Ask yourself what you are passionate about. Find out if others are passionate about it. Imagine what sort of change you would like to bring about. Creating a nonprofit organization is one way to bring it about. Your charity's vision should be its ultimate goal. If you want to start a nonprofit organization as identified by Section 501(c)(3) of the Internal Revenue Code, your organization's activities will have to be charitable and will have to fit within certain categories. In order to be considered for tax-exempt status, your purpose must be religious, scientific, educational, charitable, for example, providing relief to the poor, literary, or dedicated to public safety or the prevention of cruelty. Your organization cannot be operated for the benefit of private interests. Additionally, 501(c)(3) organizations have imposed restrictions on what lobbying activities they can conduct and what types of political engagement they can be involved in. Decide if a 501(c)(3) nonprofit organization is best suited to serve your charitable goals. In addition to nonprofit organizations, there are also charitable trusts. Trusts differ from nonprofits in that they are centered more on the allocation of money than on the allocation of community services. These private foundations typically have only one donor and do not rely on public funding. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 2. Define your mission. What is your organization going to do? What service will it provide your community? Once you've figured out your mission, write it out in a formal mission statement. A good mission statement succinctly communicates to others, volunteers, community members, and potential funders what you do and what you hope to do. The mission statement should be short, ideally 3 to 5 sentences, clear, and free of jargon. If you're having trouble finding the words, visit established organizations' websites and study their mission statements. Complement your statement with a set of goals that are both achievable and challenging. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 3. Name your charity. A charity's title often refers to its function. Many charities are named for someone related to the function that the charity provides. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 4. Create articles of incorporation. These lay out the foundations of your organization. You can find sample articles on the internet. Articles of incorporation state the purpose, name, duration of operation, structure, and other basics of your organization. Most U.S. states have forms online that you can fill out. Check your state's Secretary of State website to find the required forms. Be aware that some states want at least 2 signatures on articles of incorporation. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 5. Write the bylaws for your organization. Bylaw templates can be found online. Bylaws are the rules that govern your charity. A set of bylaws will define how decisions are made, who makes the decisions, what type of governing structure will direct the charity, how the organization will be set up, and how conflicts will be resolved. There is no legal language specifically required in bylaws. While not all states require nonprofits to have written bylaws, they are useful in helping organizations to run smoothly. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Last step. Set up a board of directors or an advisory board, and appoint a registered agent. A board of directors will help guide the charity and will make decisions. A registered agent is responsible for receiving official communications from the state. The advisory board would ideally consist of unpaid consultants experienced in nonprofit work. Add significant donors and fundraising partners to the board as the organization grows. You've reached the end of the article. Do you want to learn how to do something else? You can ask me now.
How do I collect data?
How to collect customer information. Customer information is a useful tool in helping you understand how to better market your business. To collect basic information, try simply using the information they share when they make an online order, like their address, email, and phone number. You could also ask for this information when customers call in with questions. If you want more in-depth information, create a customer satisfaction survey to help you determine what's working well in your business and what isn't. If you want to compare customer data, try using customer relationship management software to store data. These programs usually have a monthly fee, but they allow you to store and track customer information in one place. Say read steps, if you want me to read each step in detail.
Read steps.
Step 1. Collect the data your customers are already handing over. One simple way to mine data is to gather it when a customer makes an online order. You should be able to collect a name, address, email, and phone number from an online order. This process works well if you're selling just online or online and in person. It makes it easy on your customers because most are already accustomed to giving that information to receive a product. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Step 2. Ask for the information in person to connect with your customers. Start by creating a form for a mailing list, one that you will use to notify customers of specials and sales going on. Have the customers fill it out when they come into the store. Many customers are willing to sign up for this type of mail out to receive special deals. You can gather a name, an email address, and a phone number. This type of collection works well if you have an in-person store for products or services. Ask your frontline staff to encourage people to fill in these forms. Alternatively, your frontline staff can ask for the information verbally from customers and put it directly into the computers. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Step 3. Request information over the phone for convenience. When customers call in with a complaint or a question, you can ask for basic information. It's also a good time to give them a short survey about how they perceive your company. This type of data collecting works well no matter what type of business you have. You can collect information about products or services, whether you're an online or just an in-person business. For instance, you could say, "Can I have your name, email, and address so I can look up your account?" Even if they don't have an account yet, you can still ask for this information so you can contact them again. You could say, "Since you don't have an account, can I set one up for you so we can get back to you about this issue in the future?" If the customer is new, you could also ask something like, "How did you hear about our business?" Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Step 4. Use pre-order forms to encourage more people to give you information. If you have items that your customers can order before they come out, have them use a pre-order form. Collect basic information from this form, including an address, email address, and phone number. This type of form works both online and in person. However, it mainly works with products, not services. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Step 5. Take data from warranty cards to collect it inconspicuously. If you offer a warranty with any product, the customer will need to fill out an information card with biographical information to use the warranty. Once they've filled out the card, you have the information to use. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Step 6. Develop a rewards program. A rewards program gives your customers incentive to come back, and they enjoy it because they get freebies. Plus, you can make it a requirement of the program to collect information from the customer. Common rewards programs include a punch card program, where the customer gets a free item after so many punches, and a points system, where the customer gets cash to spend in your store after spending a certain amount. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Step 7. Collect a small amount of information at a time. If you ask for too much information at once, you're just going to annoy your customers. Stick to gathering as little as you can each time you interact with the customer. For instance, maybe you want to start with just their phone number or email and their name. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Last step. Move on to other demographics once customers trust you. Branch out to other types of biographical data only after you've gained your customer's trust. Gather information such as the household income range and the number of children in the household. Ask about a person's educational background and career. This information tells you more about your customer, so you can figure out what their needs are. Develop surveys that you can hand to customers in your store or that you can send out periodically to your customers via mail or email. Emphasize that these surveys remain anonymous. Use ranges for items like income, as it makes customers feel more comfortable giving you that information. You've reached the end of the article. Do you want to learn how to do something else? You can ask me now.
How do I become a teacher?
How to become a teacher in the UK. Becoming a teacher requires a lot of dedication, but you can start a rewarding career as an instructor by passing the necessary exams and getting on-the-job experience. To earn qualified teacher status or a teaching qualification, apply for a Bachelor's of Education, which will prepare you for teaching primary school. If you aspire to get a secondary education job, get a degree in the subject matter you want to teach, like biology or literature. After you graduate, earn a postgraduate certificate in education and get a C grade or higher in all your QTS exams. In addition to passing the proper tests, you'll need to finish a full year as a newly qualified teacher, where you will be monitored and tutored. Say read steps, if you want me to read each step in detail.
Read steps.
Step 1. Apply for a Bachelor's of Education if seeking a primary school job. A BED is a 3-year degree that mainly applies for aspiring primary school teachers. Primary education includes key stages 1 and 2, as defined by the UK government, grades 1 to 2 and 3 to 6, respectively. If you want to become a nursery teacher, you may be able to get a job without having a bachelor's degree, but you'll still need to be certified to work with young children. Say next. To get the next step.
Next.
Step 2. Apply for a bachelor's in your preferred subject field for a secondary education job. If secondary education, key stages 3 and 4, or grades 7 to 9 and 10 to 11, is your focus, you'll want to earn a degree that is appropriate for the subject matter you want to teach before moving on to graduate level work. For example, if you want to teach secondary school science, a biology major would be a wise choice. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Step 3. Earn a postgraduate certificate in education, PGCE. This certification will allow you to teach at all levels in the subject you earned your bachelor's in. It typically takes 1 year to earn a PGCE. In Scotland, their equivalent of a PGCE is a PGDE, postgraduate diploma in education. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Step 4. Pass all QTS, TQ in Scotland, exams. You must attain a C grade or higher in the General Certificate of Secondary Education, GCSE, exams in math and English. The GCSE exams are administered online in a testing center and also include an oral mental maths exam. Primary school teacher candidates must also take a GCSE exam in science and earn a C grade or higher. If you plan to teach in Wales, they require a B grade or higher on these exams. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Step 5. Sign up for the Initial Teacher Training, ITT, program. The ITT program typically consists of 3 separate placements at 3 different schools of about 6 to 8 weeks each. While you're at a placement, you'll be asked to do all normal activities that a regular teacher does. The only difference is that a mentor, someone with years of teaching experience under their belt, will be there to help you along. The Scottish equivalent of ITT is IT, or Initial Teacher Education. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Last step. Register with the General Teaching Council for Scotland, GTCS, if planning to teach in Scotland. The GCTS operates independent of the UK government in establishing and reviewing education standards and training standards for teachers. All teachers in Scotland are legally required to register with the GCTS. The Northern Ireland equivalent is the General Teaching Council for Northern Ireland. Being a member is mandatory if teaching in Northern Ireland. You've reached the end of the article. Do you want to learn how to do something else? You can ask me now.
How do I explain analytical science?
How to write a critical analysis. To write a critical analysis, first introduce the work you're analyzing, including information about the work's author and their purpose in writing it. As part of the introduction, briefly state your overall evaluation of the work. Then, summarize the author's key points before you use the bulk of your paper to provide your full critique of the work. Try to put each point you want to make in a separate paragraph for clarity. Finally, write a concluding paragraph that restates your opinion of the work and offers any suggestions for improvement. Say read steps, if you want me to read each step in detail.
Read steps.
Step 1. Read the source or sources carefully and take notes. Read through all of the material that you are using for your critical analysis. Highlight, underline, or make notes about important passages as you go. Look up any words, concepts, and other information that you don't understand. You may need to read the text more than once, especially if it is dense or complicated. As you read the text, consider what about it is important, worthwhile, useful, relevant, controversial, or valid. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 2. Identify the author's thesis statement. As you read the text, determine what the author is arguing for or against. Identify their thesis and underline or highlight it. A thesis statement often appears in the first 1 to 2 paragraphs of an essay. The thesis is usually a single sentence that explains the author's argument. It might be easier to find the thesis in an academic article than in a creative work, movie, or painting. If you're critiquing a work of fiction or creative nonfiction, in either written form or film form, identify one of the main themes of the story instead. For a painting, identify what the painter may be trying to get across with their work of art. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 3. Note the author's main ideas as you read. Underline or highlight all of the topic sentences and other passages that seem significant to you. These may include the author's reasons and supporting evidence that they provide throughout the text. Identifying these parts of the text will allow you to analyze its structure. In an academic article, identify the topic sentences of each paragraph or section. For works of fiction or paintings, look for scenes and imagery that seem to support the thesis. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Last step. Summarize the work in your own words. As a final way to cement the ideas you've read about in the text, write a brief summary of it. Try to keep your summary around one paragraph long and describe what the text's focus was about, including the author's main argument. If the text was a film or work of art, write a brief 1 to 2 paragraph synopsis of the film or description of the painting. You've reached the end of the article. Do you want to learn how to do something else? You can ask me now.
How do I explain polymath?
How to be successful in business. If you want
Echo.
To become a success...
What is polymath?
Hi. Ask me how to do anything.
Echo, shut up. Echo, shut up.
Thanks for using WikiHow. You can always ask another question later by saying, open WikiHow.
Echo, what is polymath?
According to Wikipedia, a polymath is an individual whose knowledge spans a significant number of subjects, known to draw on complex bodies of knowledge to solve specific problems. The earliest recorded use of the term in English is from 1624, in the second edition of The Anatomy of Melancholy by Robert Burton. The form polymathist is slightly older, first appearing in the diatribe upon the first part of the late history of tithes of Richard Montagu in 1621.
Echo, play Young Black Intelligent by Master Ace.
Here's Young Black Intelligent by Master Ace featuring Pav Bundy, Hypnotic Brass Ensemble, and Chuck D on Amazon Music.
Young Black Intelligent, this is not a first, but it feels like a curse and it weighs like an elephant. Heavy on my mind cause I feel so irrelevant. Heavy on my heart's like I'm smart for the hell of it. Heavy on my soul as I stroll through the villa again. Stranded
Echo.
On this island.
Play Haley's Song by Eminem.
Haley's Song by Eminem on Amazon Music.
Play Aladdin soundtrack.
Aladdin, original motion picture soundtrack by various artists on Amazon Music.
Echo. Play Aladdin's World by Will Smith.
I couldn't find Aladdin's World by Will Smith, but here is other music by Will Smith.
Here I go.
Alibaba, he had them 40 thieves. Shahrazadi had a echo. Play Lisa Loeb. Because up your sleeves, you got a brand of magic never
fails. You got some power in your corner. Shuffling songs by Lisa Loeb on Amazon Music.
Echo. Play You Say by Lisa Loeb.
Stay, I Miss You by Lisa Loeb on Amazon Music.
Echo. Next song.
That was the last song, starting over.
You say, I only hear what I want. Echo. Play Aladdin's World by Alan Malcolm.
Here's Aladdin's World, from Aladdin / Score, by Alan Menken, on Amazon Music.
Echo, fast forward 25 seconds. Echo, fast forward 25 seconds. Echo, go to the soundtrack for Aladdin's World.
Aladdin, A Whole New World by Geek Music on Amazon Music.
Can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid.
Echo, go back 10 seconds.
I can show you the world.
Echo, go back 6 seconds. Echo.
You last let your heart decide. I can
echo.
Open your
go back 5 seconds.
I can open your eyes.
Echo, go back 4 seconds. Echo, go forward 55 seconds. Echo, next song.
was the last song, starting over.
Echo, go to the soundtrack for Aladdin.
Aladdin, original motion picture soundtrack by various artists on Amazon Music.
Echo, next song. Echo, go forward 10 seconds.
Ahead of the bread line, one swing ahead of the sword. I steal only what I can't afford.
Echo, go back 15 seconds.
Gotta keep one jump ahead of the bread line, one swing ahead of the sword. I steal only what I can't afford. And that's everything. One jump ahead of the law, man. That's all.
Echo.
That's
no next song.
These guys don't appreciate I'm broke.
Echo. Next song. Echo. Who sings this?
This is Naomi Scott.
Echo. What is the song?
This is Speechless Part 1 by Naomi Scott.
Broken again, left with nothing to say. My voice drowned out in the thunder. But I can cry.
Echo, go back 10 seconds.
Sorry, I'm having trouble understanding right now. Please try a little later.
Echo, go back 44 seconds.
A wave meant to wash me away. A tide that is taking me under. Broken again, left with nothing to say. My voice drowned.
Echo, next song. Echo, next song. Echo, forward 30 seconds.
Hey, clear the way in the old bazaar. Hey, you, let us through. It's a brand new star. Oh, come be the first on your block to meet his eye.
Echo, next song. Echo, play classical.
Sure. The station, Ultimate Classical, on Amazon Music.
Echo, next song. Echo, next song. Echo, next song. Echo, next song. Next song. Echo. Next song. Echo. Next song. Echo, play country.
All right. Here's a station you might like. Top Country on Amazon Music.
Echo, volume down.
It's all on me. It's my mistake. I said I don't love you a little too late. But I guess there ain't ever.
Echo. Next song.
For the 65 mile an hour drive, I'll be doing 90. If it says don't look, don't touch.
Echo. Play South Park soundtrack.
Mr. Hankey's Christmas Classics by South Park on Amazon Music.
All heard of Rudolph and his shiny nose, and we all know Frosty, who's made out of snow. But all of those stories seem kind of gay, 'cause we all know who brightens up our holiday.
Echo. Next song.
I heard there is no Christmas in the silly Middle East. No trees, no snow, no Santa Claus.
There's Echo. Different religions. Next song. Echo. Next song.
Dead, dead, dead. Someday you'll be dead. Dead, dead, dead. Someday we'll all be dead. The minute we're born, we start dying. We die a little more every day.
Echo. Go back 15 seconds.
Someday we'll all be dead.
Echo. Next song.
Hark, hear the bells, sweet silver bells all seem to say ding dong and clay. Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, weak and both. Ding dong, ding dong, that is their song. Ding, joyful ring, all caroling. One seems to hear words of good cheer.
Next song.
It's hard to be a Jew on Christmas. My friends won't let me join in any games. And I can't sing Christmas songs or decorate a Christmas tree or leave water out for Rudolph, 'cause there's something wrong.
Echo.
With me.
Next song.
Saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day, on Christmas Day. I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day in the morning. And what was in those ships shall be on Christmas Day, on Christmas Day. And what shut up, turds! Was in those ships.
Echo. Next song.
Howdy, folks, let's go for a ride. Get your favorite one to sit by your side. Cuddle up in the sleigh, giddy up, Nellie Gray, and away we go.
Pog, you listen to the sleigh bells ring. You're yodeling to
Echo.
Your baby.
Next song. Echo. Open WikiHow.
I have a skill that can help you with that. Hi. Ask me how to do anything.
Echo. How do I explain the universe?
How to argue that God exists. Christianity. 5 steps. Step 1. Insist that the word of God is compatible with modern science. Remind your ideological opponent that there are no scientific theories that conclusively disprove the events mentioned in the Bible. It's possible that ancient miracles and contemporary scientific achievements only seem inconsistent with one another because the language used to explain phenomena has changed. The Big Bang Theory, for example, is often brought up to show that the teachings of Christian creationism are misguided. However, there's no way of proving that the explosion that resulted in the known universe wasn't an intentional act of creation. While it may seem counterintuitive, meeting your listener on common ground actually strengthens your position by confirming that your arguments are based on the same observations. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 2. Inform your listener about the accuracy of the Bible's depiction of Jesus. Numerous historical sources and archaeological discoveries strongly suggest that Jesus of Nazareth lived and died as the scripture tells. This may not seem like a victory in itself, but it has enormous implications. If the Bible's central figure was real, what reason is there to doubt the rest of what's written in its pages? Rather than appealing to the Bible, which your listener doesn't consider a credible source, point them towards hard scientific research, such as recent archaeological digs around Galilee and Jerusalem, which have uncovered evidence of scenes described in the New Testament. For more references to the historical Jesus, cite the writings of ancient philosophers and historians such as Tacitus, Lucian, and Pliny the Younger. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 3. Argue that God is the only satisfactory source of morality. If your listener still isn't convinced, ask them this important question: where does mankind's idea of goodness come from? Evolution may account for certain behaviors that are beneficial to the species, but it fails to address many moral judgments that appear to be universal. These can be a good starting point for a discussion on what it means to be a moral being. If your listener objects, ask them, why is it important for the species to continue? The survival of the fittest explanation can't offer a satisfactory answer to this question. Even the ancient Greeks and Romans, who valued reason more than anything else, strived to realize an ideal that they called the good. Such ideals hint at an understanding of a deeper purpose in life, perhaps one bestowed by God. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 4. Challenge your listener to explain where human consciousness came from. The Bible makes it clear that God created man in his image, which explains the unrivaled power of the human mind. The same is not true from a scientific standpoint. If all organisms are continually evolving, then why have no other creatures reached a level of consciousness anywhere near that of human beings? Emphasize that the only reason you're even able to discuss the topic at hand is because humans have the ability to invent complex languages, as well as the intelligence required to understand them. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Last step. Offer quotes from influential thinkers that support your argument. Your listener may be reluctant to accept your views because they've labeled you as biased or short-sighted. They'll have no choice, however, but to recognize the wisdom of respected figures such as Albert Einstein, who is famously quoted as saying, "When the solution is simple, God is answering." Other notable personalities who have alluded to a belief in God include Walt Whitman, who wrote, "In the faces of men and women I see God, and in my own face in the glass," and Paul Tillich, who said, "He who knows about depth knows about God." Quotations don't constitute evidence in themselves, but they can lend added credibility to an already strong argument. You've reached the end of the article. Do you want to learn how to do something else?
Echo.
You can ask me now.
Shut up. Echo, next song.
Thanks for using WikiHow. You can always ask another question later by saying, open WikiHow.
Echo, next song. Echo, what is Christmas?
Christmas, a shortened version of Christ's Mass, is an annual celebration commemorating Jesus Christ's birth. Western churches celebrate it on December 25th, a date thought to be tied to the winter solstice. The first recorded Christmas celebration was in Rome in 336 AD. The Puritans banned Christmas in the 17th century. It quickly became legal again, but was still associated with misbehavior. Charles Dickens and other writers reinvented the holiday, associating it with family and gift-giving.
Echo, what is astrology?
According to Wikipedia, astrology is a pseudoscience that claims divine information about human affairs and terrestrial events by studying the movements and relative positions of celestial objects. Astrology has been dated to at least the 2nd millennium BCE, and has its roots in calendrical systems used to predict seasonal shifts and to interpret celestial cycles as signs of divine communications.
There's no beef love to be found.
Echo, how do I learn astrology?
For help with that question, go to the help and feedback section of the Alexa app.
Echo, open WikiHow.
I have a skill that can help you with that. Hi. Ask me how to do anything.
How do I explain the sun?
How to protect yourself from the sun. While you're out enjoying the sun, it's important to protect yourself with the right clothing and sunscreen. Use sunscreen of at least 30 SPF to avoid getting sunburn. Apply it 20 minutes before you leave and then every 2 hours that you're out in the sun. Wear a wide-brimmed hat to protect your head, ears, and neck, and stick to loose, long-sleeved clothing to cover your skin. Don't forget to take your sunglasses to help block harmful rays from your eyes. When it's really sunny outside, stay in the shade or indoors during 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. when you're most likely to get sunburned or sunstroke. Say read steps, if you want me to read each step in detail.
Read steps.
Step 1. Choose a sunscreen with a safe SPF. You should wear sunscreen each time you go out during the day, even when it's overcast. Make sure you select a sunscreen with a strong enough sun protection factor, SPF, to protect you from UV rays. Go for a sunscreen of at least SPF 30. The SPF should be written somewhere on the sunscreen bottle. If you have cancer or pre-cancer, get a sunscreen with SPF 45 or higher. Look for the words broad spectrum on the bottle. This assures you the sunscreen protects you from UVA rays in addition to UVB rays. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 2. Apply sunscreen 20 to 30 minutes before leaving your home. Do this each time you leave your house during the daytime when the sun is out. This is especially important if you'll be exposed to the sun for more than 30 minutes. If you have trouble remembering to apply sunscreen, try leaving yourself a note on the door before going out. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 3. Reapply sunscreen every 2 hours. Keep track of how long you've been outside. You should make the effort to reapply sunscreen every 2 hours so it stays effective. If you're inside all day and go back out before the sun sets, you should also reapply sunscreen. If you've been swimming, you may want to reapply sunscreen after getting out of the water even if 2 hours have not yet passed. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Last step. Apply the correct amount. Many people do not realize how much sunscreen you actually need for adequate protection. You need at least 45 milliliters, 1.5 fluid ounce, of sunscreen to cover all exposed skin on your body. This is about as much sunscreen as could fit in an average shot glass. Smooth sunscreen over rather than rubbing it. Make sure to cover any skin that will be exposed, including the skin on your back. Have someone else help you apply sunscreen if there's any spot you can't reach. You've reached the end of the article. Do you want to learn how to do something else? You can ask me now.
Echo, what is a phytotoxin?
Hi. Ask me how to do anything.
Echo, shut up.
Thanks for using WikiHow. You can always ask another question later by saying,
Echo,
open WikiHow.
What is a phytotoxin?
Phytotoxin's definition is any substance produced by plants that is similar in its properties to extracellular bacterial toxin.
Echo, what is giant hogweed?
Heracleum mantigasianum, commonly known as giant hogweed, is a monocarpic perennial herbaceous flowering plant in the carrot family Apiaceae. H. mantigasianum is also known as cartwheel flower, giant cow parsley, giant cow parsnip, or hogsbin. In New Zealand, it is also sometimes called wild parsnip or wild rhubarb. Giant hogweed is native to the Western Caucasus region of Eurasia.
Echo, what are the effects of giant hogweed?
Here's something I found on the web. According to Medscape.com, erythema, edema, vesiculation, hyperpigmentation, and desquamation are typical phototoxic skin effects.
Echo, what are the phototoxic skin effects?
Sorry, I'm not sure.
Echo, explain photo skin effects.
Sorry, I'm not sure.
Echo, next song.
Long press button, expand, accessibility, volume, slider, slider, ringtone, one, slider, media, 0%, polymath, slider, accessibility,
small droplets from the nose or mouth that are expelled when an infected person coughs or exhales. These droplets land on objects and surfaces around the person. Other people catch the virus by touching these objects or surfaces or by breathing in droplets when near an infected individual. Always stay at least 2 meters, 6 feet, away from a person who is sick to avoid contact with coronavirus droplets. The coronavirus is thought to mainly spread via people with symptoms. There have been reports of cases where people tested positive for coronavirus but showed no active symptoms. To best ensure safety from coronavirus, avoid large group settings and do your best to stay away from anyone who may have had contact with the virus, even if they don't appear to be sick. To protect your home from coronavirus, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention suggests cleaning high-touch surfaces with a disinfectant daily. Clean your doorknobs, kitchen counters, tables, toilets, phones, keyboards, and bathroom fixtures every day. According to Johns Hopkins University, disinfectant products are thought to be effective against
Echo.
Coronavirus because of the
music volume
envelope of the virus. If you are able, avoid traveling to places with known coronavirus cases, and visit cdc.gov for updated travel health notices. Say read steps, if you want me to read each step in detail.
Read steps.
Step 1.
Echo.
Stay away from people who are coughing or sneezing.
Echo.
Since COVID-19
play
is a
music
respiratory
volume
infection,
two.
Coughing and sneezing are common symptoms. Additionally, coughing and sneezing both release the virus into the air, so they may increase your risk of infection. Keep your distance from people who appear to have symptoms of an upper respiratory infection. If it's appropriate, ask the person to stay away from you. You could say, I noticed you were coughing. I hope you feel better soon, but please keep your distance from me so I don't get sick. If you know someone that has been around sick people, it's a good idea to distance yourself from them, too. You never know if that person got sick. Say next, to get the next step.
Next.
Step 2. Wash your hands with soap and water to minimize your infection risk. The best way to prevent COVID-19 is to wash your hands as often as possible. Wick your hands with warm water, then apply a mild soap. Work the soap into a lather for 20 to 30 seconds, then rinse your
Echo.
Hands clean under warm running water. This
Echo.
Is about how long it takes
Next
to sing
song.
A happy birthday song to yourself twice. So pretend you're celebrating someone's birthday. The World Health Organization recommends not just rubbing your hands palm to palm, but interlacing and interlocking your fingers in a variety of different ways to make sure every surface is clean. Use the paper towel to dry your hands off and to turn
Echo.
Off the faucet.
Next song.
Always wash your hands before you eat or drink anything. However, it's also best to wash your hands anytime you're out in public or after you're around someone you suspect may be sick. If you can't wash your hands, use a hand sanitizer that contains 60 to 95% alcohol. Alcohol percentages higher than 95% are actually Echo. Less effective.
Next song.
Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 3. Keep your hands away from your eyes, nose, and mouth. You may come into contact with coronavirus on a surface,
Echo.
Like a doorknob or a countertop. When this happens, the germs can linger on your hands, so you can easily infect yourself if you touch your face with dirty hands. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth in case the virus is on your skin. If you need to touch your face, wash your hands first so you're less likely to infect yourself. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 4. Don't
Echo.
Shake hands with people,
Play next song.
Whether they show symptoms or not. Unfortunately, people who are infected with COVID-19 may spread the illness even if they aren't showing symptoms. You might say, I'm happy to meet you. Normally I'd shake your hand, but the CDC recommends limiting personal contact right now to help prevent the spread of coronavirus. Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Echo. Play next
step
song.
Step 5. Disinfect high-touch surfaces daily using a product that kills viruses. Unfortunately, coronavirus can linger on surfaces, such as doorknobs, countertops, and faucets. Use a spray disinfectant or bleach wipes to clean these surfaces daily. Make sure the surface stays wet for about 10 minutes so it effectively kills the virus. This limits the risk of the virus lingering on the surfaces and potentially
Echo.
Causing an infection.
Echo.
In your home, disinfect your front doorknob, kitchen counters, bathroom counters, and faucets. At work, clean surfaces that people tend to touch, such as doorknobs, stair railings, tables, and surface counters. You can also make disinfectant by mixing 1 cup, 240 milliliters, of bleach with 1 gallon, 3.8 liters, of warm water. Say next to get the next step.
Echo.
Next.
Next. Song.
Last step. Avoid bad information and unconfirmed rumors about coronavirus.
Echo.
Myths about COVID-19 have spread on social media, sometimes causing unnecessary fear.
Play Hindi
Get the
music.
Facts about COVID-19 from a reliable source like the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, or the World Health Organization, WHO. Additionally, it's helpful to fact-check your sources before making any decisions. While this new strain of coronavirus was first thought to have originated in China, it is not connected to Asian people. Don't treat someone differently or distance yourself from someone because they are Asian. Treat everyone with kindness and remember that anyone
Echo.
Can get infected no matter
Next
what
song.
Their race
Echo.
Or ethnicity is.
Next song.
According to WHO, you cannot get COVID-19 from mail or products. WHO also denies that there are specific foods that prevent COVID-19. We've reached the end of the article. Do you want to learn how to do something else? You can ask me now.
Echo. How do I prevent cross-contamination?
How to avoid
Echo.
Cross-contamination.
Next song.
4 steps. Step 1. Keep ready to eat and raw foods separate in your shopping cart. Drippings from raw meat, poultry, and seafood can contaminate other foods even before you head to the checkout line.
Echo.
Place raw foods in the bottom
Play
of your
next
shopping
song.
Cart as far away from ready-to-eat items as possible.
Echo.
Never store meat
Play
on
next
top of
song.
Produce or place a bag of veggies directly on top of a package of raw meat. Ready-to-eat foods are items that don't need to be cooked or have already been cooked. Examples include fruits, vegetables, and deli meats. Foods that aren't ready to eat, such as raw chicken breast or raw ground beef, need to be cooked before you eat them. Cooking raw meats kills germs and makes them safe to eat. If drippings from raw chicken breast get on an apple, eating the apple will
Echo.
Put you at risk of getting sick.
Play Latin American.
Say next to get the next step.
Next.
Step 2. Bag raw meat, poultry, and seafood separately at checkout. If you bag groceries yourself, place raw and ready-to-eat foods in separate bags. When you don't bag your own groceries, make sure the employee bagging them keeps raw foods away from produce, cheese, and other ready-to-eat foods. If possible, bag a package of raw meat, poultry, or seafood in plastic or paper before placing it into
Echo.
A reusable tote.
Next song.
Say next. To get the next step.
Next.
Step 3. Get your groceries to the fridge within 2 hours. Raw meats, dairy, and eggs need to be refrigerated within 2 hours. Schedule your errands so your groceries won't have to hang out in the car for an extended period of time. If you can't get to a fridge within 2 hours, store your groceries in an insulated bag or cooler. Say next to get the next step.
Echo.
Next
song.
Last step. Wash reusable totes with hot, soapy water. Don't store your reusable totes in your vehicle's trunk or back.
Thank you. Me di cuenta que por esa sonrisa yo vivo.
Yo quiero conocerte como nadie te conoce. Dime que me
Echo. Next song. Echo. Next song. Echo. Play blues.
Okay. The station. All blues. Songs on music.
Echo, next song. Song. Echo. Next song.
Me
Echo. Next song.
It's not me you're dying for, how she's feeling. Than she ever has before. She's so freaking, I'm drowning slowly. Because I'm getting low.
Echo. Next song. Echo. Next song.
Vet center seemed like the best bet. I feel finding someone who you're comfortable with.
Filled with fresh fruits and vegetables, courtesy of the LA Bowl, an upcoming NCAA Division I bowl game.
Here at the LA Bowl, we're a new bowl, new here to the community, and we've been focusing on several of these types of events throughout not only Inglewood, but also the Los Angeles community. We've received an overwhelming amount of positive feedback.
A company called Melissa's Produce also donated to the giveaway. Families with children received backpacks filled with school supplies.
So we know that we've been facing different challenges right now when it comes to the pandemic and different, you know, things that have been happening recently. But having people supporting us and giving us this type of supplements to, you know, just go through our lives, it really means a lot.
Inglewood Mayor James T. Butts says the city has been especially hard hit by the COVID-19
partnership, and it's just a start of great things to come.
Next song.
While many residents are excited about the stadium, others regularly express concerns on social media about gentrification, rising rents, and they've criticized the city for offering the site's developers big tax breaks instead of truly helping those in need. And
SoFi cost $1 billion to construct and is described as the most expensive sports stadium ever built. It's scheduled to officially open next month, but likely without fans in the stadium, excuse me, due to the pandemic. Contest for students, hoping the public will help them narrow down 5 artists to become finalists in the competition. We got a chance to speak with one of the artists,
Echo.
And stay
next
tuned.
Song.
You don't want to miss it.
Keto is simple. By removing carbs, your body is forced to burn fat.
For twinsies.
Echo.
At CVS, flu
next
shots
song.
Can be free. Safe and quick, so the whole family can get them.
Now we're twinsies.
Get $5 off 20 with each free flu shot at CVS.
DSW is your sneaker headquarters for the whole family.
Get the coolest stuff from your favorite brands
like Nike, Adidas, Converse, and Vans.
Women's, men's, and kids all in one place. See you soon at DSW.
In 1850, a promise was made.
Echo.
To back you during
next
times
song.
Of plenty. And during times like this. During times of plenty. At American Express. And whatever
Echo.
Comes next.
Play soul music.
That in the wealthiest nation in the world, we have to be faced with and see so many struggling so profoundly with economic injustice every day. As our dear friend and great leader Bishop Barber has noted, before the pandemic
Echo.
Began, there were
Echo.
Over 140 million, mind you, 140 million poor and low wealth 18.3% of Black Americans and 18.3% of Latinx Americans. This means that simply by virtue of being born a person of color, one is more than twice as likely to experience poverty in the United States as their white counterparts. And we want everyone lifted out of poverty. But when you look at the disproportionate numbers of people of color, and when you look at the fact that we have not made any gains, this is just something we have to see as a reflection, once again, of systemic racism that we must tackle at the same time that we see. It's really beyond cruel, and I think right now we see them for who they are. Not only do we need the big relief bill, the Heroes Bill that we passed several months ago, we also need massive public investment to take systemic racism and economic inequalities. We need to dismantle and disrupt those policies and those systems that create the inequalities. We've got to do that, and thank God for our young people in the streets who are pushing and insisting that we do that. We need a living wage, and yes, I support Medicare for All. We need an end to food insecurity. Look at the lines of people, people who have never lived below the poverty line. Now, middle-income people are waiting in line just for a box of food in America.
Echo.
We need an expansion of Social Security. We've got to eliminate the wealth gap among communities of color and policies that treat housing, mind you, housing as a basic human right.
And here is
personally and professionally. He's confronted devastating loss, finding purpose in the darkness and inspiring others along the way to do so as well.
Next song.
And I can speak from experience, because when my husband unexpectedly passed away, he often said, the American people have never, ever let us down, and they never will. We are in difficult, dark times, but with Joe Biden leading us, we will conquer any challenge. When I gave my remarks the other day, I started off by saying in a history class in the future, children
play
will
reggae.
Be learning about this moment that we're in today, and that they'll be learning about our pain and our grief and our worry, but that they will also be learning about a man named Joe Biden who helped restore dignity and decency to our government and integrity to our democracy. And they'll learn about how we, as individuals, as a collective, as a united party and people, conquered a pandemic.
Tell me about Bob Marley.
Stood up against racial injustice, and also worked to build our economy back better. And they'll learn about his leadership and how he gave that young generation that was focused on last night a fighting chance.
So how did this process all start? I mean, how long has it been?
I first applied at the beginning of the year. I submitted my doodle. I think...